So in this video, we're going to talk about Vercel Blob Storage, which is an object storage service from Vercel that allows you to store static files like images and videos and audio files. And we're going to implement that inside of this blogging site we created a couple of weeks ago on the channel where we used Novel, which is a Notion style rich text editor. I'm going to include the link in the description and also in the show notes if you haven't seen that video. And we're going to implement this blob storage inside of this blogging experience. So if you remember, we had this form that allows us to create a new blog post. We can give it a title. And then we have this editor body content here that allows you for a similar editing experience as Notion. If you've used Notion before, you have this slash command that opens up different type of elements you can choose. For example, heading. This is a heading. You can have normal text. If I can type, you can embed a YouTube video, for example. You can write a tweet. So if you haven't seen the video, it really is an interesting rich text editor that you can use in any application that needs user-generated content. Now, one of the features that there is here is this image. So if you click this right now, it opened up my file picker and it just gives you this toast notification that the blob read write token environment variable is not found. Therefore, it's going to read images locally instead. So it shows the image here because it's just turning it into binary data locally and putting it inside the content of the body of our blog post over here. But what we want to do here instead is to, whenever the user actually is selecting an image, we want to upload this image to our blob storage, in this case, Vercel Blob Storage, that we can just integrate and connect with this project very easily from our Vercel dashboard, and then get a URL back and then store that URL so that we can just show the image here inside of our deployed website. Now I'm going to jump into the code and walk through the high level of the project. Really, we're not going to dive deep into how we created this blogging site. Rather, we just want to talk about the file storage or the image storage system using the Vercel Blob. So from a high level, let me just make this full screen so you can see this better. There we have it. So let's jump inside of our code real quick here. Let me close all of these tabs. And then from a high level, we have this app. We're using the app directory in our Next.js application. So inside of our homepage, we have this content form, which isn't really a form. So if I just close these functions to look at this from a high level, we have an input for text and for our title and slug. We have this editor, which is the Novel editor that uses TipTap behind the scenes to create this rich text editor. If you want to learn more about how we created this, I definitely recommend watching that video. The editor comes in with different plugins, selectors, and extensions that you can allow different functionalities like the tweet, the YouTube embed, and uploading images. Now, right now, we have this image upload that is basically calling this API /upload endpoint inside of our own application, trying to upload the image to a service. We do have this API upload route created, but we're not actually benefiting from it because we haven't configured a blob storage inside of our Vercel account, which is what we're going to do in this video. So let's go back to Vercel documentation. Vercel Blob, as I mentioned, it's a scalable, cost-effective object storage for storing static assets such as images, videos, and audio files. You can store it, you can use it for storing any type of files, as you can see here. Now, there's two ways that we can use or upload our images using Vercel Blob. We're going to first enable this inside of our dashboard, inside of our project, and then we're going to talk about different ways you can actually use it to upload to your blob storage. Now, we have talked briefly about Vercel storage. There are different storage services available on Vercel. The Vercel KV is a key value pair, like a Redis instance. We have used this for rate limiting before. There's a video linked in the description. You can check that out. Vercel Postgres is a Neon Postgres, so it's a serverless Postgres that you can use easily inside your Vercel project. And in this video, we're going to focus on the blob which is another service also provided from Vercel storage services. So if you go to your project, this is where I have deployed this Next Novel or the blogging site. It's called Next Novel. Now what you can do is come on the storage tab, and here you can create a new storage system and select blob here. It's currently in beta, but it is available to free and hobby and pro users. So you can select blob, click continue. You can give it a name. Here it is Next Novel Blob. So let's create. And this is going to ask you if you want to provide this same storage to all different environments. I'm going to select connect. And what this is going to do is going to automatically create this blob read write token and put it inside of your project, so you don't have to do anything as far as the deployed version of your site. This is already set inside of your project, but if you want to also use and test this inside of your local development, there's two things you need to do. One is to first copy this and go back to your project and go back inside of your .env. I've created this .env.template here so that we can have this blob read write token. We can copy it here. I'm going to copy mine inside .env because that's the real file that I'm using. The template is just to guide what you need. We need a database URL. This is our Neon database, and also this blob URL. So the first thing is that you need to copy this environment variable. And the second thing is that you need to run your local development in a service like ngrok that allows or tunnels your local server to an HTTPS, so Vercel can communicate back to your application when the upload actually finishes. Because it sends, once you actually upload this image, it needs to send back the success and gives you back the URL. So you need, it needs to be able to communicate back to your local dev. And if you're just running it in your local dev server, it won't be able to. So you have to run a service like ngrok, which I'm running. So I have started my dev server on localhost 3000, but I'm also in this second terminal running my ngrok application, which just points or tunnels this local dev to an HTTPS public URL that Vercel can talk to. So let's go back to our Vercel dashboard. Here, it has a very simple example of what you can do to use this put method from Vercel blob. This is the SDK we need to install. And then you can call this put method, give your file a name and the actual file. Here is just a string. And then pass in some options object and then get the URL for your file back, which you can store in a database, in our case, and then use that image inside of your project. Now, if you scroll down, let me just close this toast notifications. If you scroll down, there is a getting started guide over here that you can tap between Svelte and Next.js. So it tells you step number one, prepare your local project. This is what we did. You can either copy the environment variable or use Vercel env pool command. You can link your Vercel project to your local dev, and then you can run Vercel env pool, which is very efficient into pulling all of the environment variables that you have here into your local dev. Then you have to install the package. So we've done the first step. Let's just go ahead and install the package here. I'm going to go to the first terminal, npm add Vercel blob. Now we need to use it in code. So this example creates a page to upload files using Next.js, the app router server upload method. So here we are using a client component, a form that on submit is going to hit our API endpoint. So it's using API endpoints. This is what we're going to use as well. And this is the API endpoint. Here we're expecting a post request, and inside of that post request, we're getting the body which contains the file. And then we're calling the same put method from Vercel blob to actually write that file name inside of our storage. And then here it just returns the blob, but we want to actually get the URL, which we're going to do. Now, this is from the dashboard. If you go to the documentation as well, you can see under Vercel blob, as I mentioned, there's two ways really to upload your images inside of your projects. One is from your server, one is from the client. And the main difference is the size limit. So the way that the server upload works is that you have a form on the client side, and you handle the submission either through API routes. That's the traditional way of handling form submissions. And inside of your API routes, which is a serverless function that runs inside of your Next.js app, you can upload this image to your Vercel blob, get the URL back, and do whatever you need to do, such as storing it inside of your database. You can also use a server action. So if you're handling your form submissions using a server action instead of having an API route, inside the server action, you can actually use the put method from Vercel blob to upload this image. Server actions run on the server. So again, this is using the server to upload the image. Now, server actions are like API endpoints, just serverless functions that has a limitation for how big the body can be when you are hosting your functions or your Next.js app on Vercel. And that's 4.5 megabyte. So if you're using server to upload your images, there is a limitation because of the limitation of serverless functions in Vercel. Now, if you have a long running server, that won't be a limitation. Or if you choose to upload from client side directly, again, you don't have this limitation. The file uploads can be up to 5 terabytes. So this is going to actually communicate with your server to generate a specific token before you're able to upload from the client side. It is secure, but it only the difference to me is that in one, you have this limitation for the file size, in the other, you don't. In this video, we're going to focus on server uploads, but you can definitely dive into this part of the docs here. So if I open this, there is server upload quick start and the client upload quick start. So we're going to go to the server upload, and for the server upload, again, there's two ways with the API routes. That's the traditional way of handling forms. We're going to do that here. Or server actions, which is just functions you define on the server. They run on the server, but you can call them from the client, and you can get the form data, the file actually selected, and use the server action to upload your file. So the first step here, again, is to install. We have already done that. Create a blob store by going to your project, to your storage tab, and creating a new one. That's what we have already done. We're going to prepare your local project. That's just copying this blob read write token. Actually, I haven't done this, so let me pause, copy this for the project, and be back. Okay, I've copied my environment variable or my token. Now, another way other than copying it is just using the Vercel pool, which I've explained. So server uploads are perfectly fine as long as you do not need to upload files larger than 4.5 megabyte on Vercel, because this is a limitation for serverless functions. It has nothing to do with the file storage system. It's just the serverless functions have these limitations. If that's the case, you can use client uploads. Now, the first example is using a server action. As you can see here, we've defined this server action with the use server client. This function is defined and runs on the server, but you can call it from the client side. Now here, we're not using client side. This is just all running on the server. We are passing this upload image server action to the action prop of our form. Inside of it, we are getting the form data. It's automatically passed to our server action by React. We are getting the image as a file. And we are using a put function from Vercel blob. That's the package that we just installed. To then upload an image, we give it a name, the actual file, and an options object that sets the access of this file to public. We then revalidate the path and then return the blob. Okay. Now, if you're showing this blob, this image, anywhere inside of your application, you need to actually update your next config to accept images from that specific remote storage system that is pointing to your Vercel blob storage. We're going to see this inside of our application shortly as well. And this is the case if you're using the next image component, which you should if you want better, more optimized images inside of your application. If you're using the regular image HTML component. You don't need this, but with NextImage, you have to actually define safe URLs or domains that are hosting your images. Now here, as you can see, it has an image gallery component. It is fetching all of our images using this list function from Vercel Blob. And for each image, we are just rendering an image. We're mapping over all of our images. And for each one, we are rendering this next image component, passing it to the image URL. And because we're using next image component, we had to set that config up top. Now, this was using a server action. You can also use API endpoints, and this is the second example here. So inside of the app router, we have a form. This time we are handling it traditionally with an on submit. So we are not using actions or server actions, preventing the default, actually getting a reference to the file and reading that file, using a fetch to hit our own API endpoint. So we have to create an API endpoint as we have inside of our own app, where we are going to respond to a post request where the body is actually that selected file. It's getting the blob back, setting the blob, and then actually showing the blob here and a link to download the blob. Now to create the server upload route, this is your route handlers inside Next.js. You would export named functions that corresponds to HTTP methods. So this is going to respond to a post request. If you're not familiar with route handlers, I'll link a video in the description where I walk through what they are and how you would use them, but they're basically similar to API endpoints. So you're getting the file name. If you have passed a file name already inside the query strings that was hitting this API endpoint, and same function to just create this file or upload this file to our Vercel Blob storage. It's very easy to actually use this with this single put method and downloading this package. You can communicate or upload images to your blob storage, get a URL back, store it inside of your database, and you're done. So this is by far the easiest way that I have found to store images inside of my projects. If your project has so many different images, you might look into, you know, different services and how this is going to cost you. But for me, for example, for these type of applications that don't have tremendous amount of images, it is actually the most cost-effective or the easiest way that I can spin up a file storage that it's already tied into my projects, because my project is hosted on Vercel, my file storage is already on Vercel, your Postgres or your KV can also be there. So it just makes it easier to integrate this into your project if your project is not heavy on images. To be honest with you, I haven't compared the pricing, so maybe even it is cost-effective if you have a tremendous amount of images, but you definitely have to look into your usage specifically and the cost there. Now, testing your page, you could just run it. So this is all we needed. It was just a post, and this is what actually we're going to do inside of our own application. So let's go back to the code now here. Let me close this terminal. Now, as I mentioned, the form or our editor has this functionality for the image upload that calls this API endpoints that we already have, API/upload. We already had this route handler inside of our application, but it wasn't working properly because we didn't have the necessary environment variable to work with our blob storage, and we didn't have the package. Now, let's see what's going on here. So inside of this post handler, if you don't have this environment variable set, it is going to return a response. That's the same response that we have seen inside of the toast notification in the beginning of this demo, where I tried to upload an image and it wasn't working because I didn't have the token. And if we do have this token, now we can continue. We get the file out of the body of the request. We can set a file name. As you can see, get the content type from the content type coming from the request header. And the file type, getting it out of this, the first section. And then Once we have this, we're going to create a file name that includes the file name and the file type. Just all housekeeping up until this point. And all you need to do really to upload this, as we have seen in the documentation, is to use the put function from Vercel Blob. Pass a file name, pass the actual file, and pass an options object. In this case, we are passing the content type, sets the content type that we received, and then access public. And then we're returning this response with a blob, which is going to then use the URL that that's returned in this object to then store it inside of our content, inside of our editor. And now our content is going to have that URL so that we can use it inside of our blog post. Okay, so that's all we need to do to actually make this work, because we've already had this code over here. And now we have set our blob storage. So let's go back to our application now. And if I just refresh this and go ahead to create, I think I have stopped the dev server. So let's restart our dev server here. Again, this is pointing to a public URL using ngrok. And that's what you need for this to work properly. So again, have that in mind. You might try to test it locally and it won't work. It uploads the image, but it is not able to communicate with Vercel. So let's say image storage. This didn't run quite right because JavaScript hasn't been loaded, I guess. So image storage. Storage, and here let's just have a normal text, and here I'm going to hit slash and image. It opens the file picker. I can select a file here, and now it's uploading an image. Upload successfully. You can see the toast notification that because we have the necessary connection to our Vercel blob, and now this created our file. I can go ahead and create this blog post, which is going to store the content of this blog to my database and then redirect me to blog4/datslog, which is just exactly what we had, normal text and the image. If we go back to our post page, we should be able to see this image storage blog post that we just created that contains our image over here. Now if I go back to my dashboard for Vercel, under the storage we should be able to see our files over here. So let me see where this is. So browser, maybe, yes. So we can see this image was recently uploaded. You can click on it. It opens up metadata about this image, what it is, and the headers that was set when creating it. You can download it and whatnot. You can search based on the name. You can also create new folders. So when you are writing images inside of your Vercel blob storage, you can either create folders here, or when you're actually writing it inside of your code, so where you are defining this file name, you can create a hierarchy of folders and subfolders with this slash. So you can say, I don't know, blog/images or assets/images, or maybe even dividing them based on the project. So next novel /images /, and then the actual file name. Now, this slashes is for organization purposes. It doesn't actually have the same folder structure as your file system, but it if you have /s inside the name that you're passing in, and that's actually the way that all of cloud storage systems works. Like for example, Google Cloud Storage, it's the same way. If you include /s inside of the file name, it just takes that or interprets that as folders and creates that folders for organization purposes. So when you are looking inside of this, it's not like all of your images in one place. There's going to be different folders, but you can also do this from inside of your Vercel dashboard as well. So that's all you need to do really to have this working. Now it is storing our images remotely inside of our Vercel project. It integrates automatically with our deployed version. So if I now go ahead and update The code right here, because we've made some changes, primarily we just added the Vercel blob storage and this add. So what we can do here is we can deploy our changes, and inside of our deployed version, this will automatically work because this blob storage is already integrated. So this token is already set inside of our project in NextNovel. So you don't have to add anything else. So if I go, for example, here to settings, to environment variables, you'd be able to see that we have this blob read write token already set up in our project. So once we push the changes, the deployed version already works as it should. Let me just make this smaller. That's a wrap for this video, folks. We talked about Vercel blob storage. It's the easiest way that I found to integrate file storage system inside of your projects. You can use it for image, videos, and media files. There's two primary ways to upload images or files to your Vercel blob storage, from server or from client. In this video, we just showed the server side. You can use it inside of your API route handlers or inside your server actions in response to a form submission. You just use the SDK from the server side. In the client side, it's just the same way. It uses the /client side of the same package that you installed. The main difference between the two different strategies is how big your files are. If you're deploying your project into Vercel, this serverless functions or this API routes or server actions are running as serverless functions. And there is a limitation for how big the body of your serverless function can be. For Vercel hosted functions are 4.5 megabytes. So therefore your files cannot be bigger than that because the serverless function can't handle it. If you have bigger files, you have to choose the client upload, which is going to communicate to your server, generate a token to then be able to upload this image to your Vercel blob storage directly from the client side, which eliminates the file size restriction. You can dive into that part of it. It's as easy as the server side if you need uploading files bigger than 4.5 megabytes. And that's a wrap, folks. If you have any questions, hit me up in the comments. If you want me to cover more stuff about storage or file storage in general for different services, let me know down in the comments, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.